guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Joey, and in today's part two, we are going to be discussing about the difference between American university and colleges and Dutch university and colleges. So basically, upper level studies. And this is my part two on my schooling system. We have talked about the high school and we have talked about how it leads up into the universities. Now, we are just gonna basically discuss colleges and universities. So let's go ahead and get started with our American schooling system. And just the way our high school schooling system is really easy and simple, so is our university system as well. We have got two different types of schools. We've got colleges and we've got universities. And basically, at a college, you can only get up to a bachelor's degree. And in a university, you can get a bachelor's, a master's, and a PhD as well. So those are basically the two different things. So if you went to a college, for example, I went to Marymount Manhattan College, which is a university, but it is only a four-year school. Now, if you go, for example, to the University of Michigan, there you can go for 4 years of your bachelor's, and then you can get a master's, and then you can go ahead and get a PhD. So, simple in that sense. In the Netherlands, we've got a whole different system. You've got your MBO, which is 2 to 4 years. Now, that is a study that is much more practical, much more hands-on. And for example, you would study for example, car mechanic or office manager. Those are the things that you would do in that sort of study. Then you have your HBO, which is basically just a bachelor's degree. It is a University of Applied Sciences and it's 4 years. So what that means is that it's applied science. So you're learning how to apply the things that have been researched into regular life. And for example, you could do nursing, you're applying the science. Not so much theory. You would do international business, business administration, things like that. So it is very focused just on that study. So if you're doing nursing, chances are you're probably only taking courses that are dealing with nursing. So it's very, very microscopic into your study. Then, of course, you've got the last one, the university, where you can do your bachelor's, your master's, and your PhD. Now, here, the universities are much more theoretical, much more research-based. So you could also do a business administration study, but of course, you would do that with much more research-based, much more theory, and less about the practice. Or maybe not less about the practice, but equally about the research as well. And in these universities, you can also, of course, get your master's and get your PhDs. One thing that we have in the United States that you guys do not have here is the associate's degree. The associate's degree is a two-year degree that you can get similar to your MBO. It's basically 2 years and you can do this for fixing refrigerators or a nursing. You can have a two-year nursing degree where you're more of like a nurse's assistant. So we have that as well, also in colleges as well and universities. In America, we also have private and public universities. Private universities are not funded by the government, or they are very little bit funded by the government, and they are basically do not have to follow the rules of the what the government says you have to enforce or you have to teach. For example, public schools have to enforce and they have to teach certain things, whereas private schools, because they are funded by us, the students who pay, they can create their own curriculum. Where here in the Netherlands, I believe that you guys have private schools, but they are very different in the way that they work. Last but not least, we also have our Ivy Leagues. The Ivy Leagues are basically your top tier schools, where like the highest GPA, highest percentage average of grades, those people, that's where they go. So they have law schools, doctor schools, they have all these schools, but they are the top universities where the top of the top go. So if you have a degree from one of those schools, you're more likely to get a job than if you don't from another school. For example, Harvard Law School, the best lawyers come from Harvard Law School versus another law school like that. Last but not least, which I think is the biggest bomb shocker of our lives, is the cost. Here in the Netherlands, the cost for a student is around 2,000 euros because the government pays for anything above the 2,000 euros. So no matter how much school actually is, you're paying 2,000 euros. And you can also get the government student loan with 0% interest, and you can get a free Metro card or a free NS card. That was so New York of me. A free NS card as well. So 2,000 euros for one full year, that sounds to me like a bargain. Now, I'm gonna give you the averages of the schooling system in the United States. So the two averages are for a private school and a public school. So let's start with a public school, the cheaper option. The average public school cost is $20,770 per year, okay? And if you're going for 4 years, how about we do the math? You're gonna be spending about $81,000 for your 4-year degree. Of course, you have scholarships and you have grants from the government. What is a grant? It is free money that the government gives you if you are under a certain amount of yearly income, or your parents are. It's not much, but it really, really helps. It might be, for example, 5,000 a year is like the norm that you can get. Now, the price for a private school is $46,985 a year. Now, that is what I spent. I went to a private school in New York City, and I spent a lot of money studying for my 4 years. I do not regret anything in my life. I never want to regret anything, but I think that if there was one thing that I regret, it's taking out $80,000 in student loans to pay for my education, because currently I am paying that back. Now, $80,000, that is, of course, not including I had scholarships and things like that. So that is what I have to pay. Now, the prices are extraordinary. The students coming out of the United States schooling system have so much debt, it is not funny. It is really doesn't even start you in the right path. So I really think that the university system here in the Netherlands is amazing. And if I have any children, I would love for them to study here, because I think that you get an amazing education for a little amount of money, and the education is good anywhere in the US and here in Europe. So I hope this answers a lot of your questions. If you have any comments or anything to add on it, please let me know, comment below. And as always, give me a thumbs up, subscribe, habanero, click on my face, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!